Hey, it's John at Enduring Charm. So my remodeling business does not include air conditioning and heating, but sometimes I end up working on this stuff for family and friends. And this particular air conditioning and heating system has been featured on some other videos. In fact, you may remember I did a video on how to clean out a condensate pump. So today we have a little bit different problem. This thing was running all night. It's very hot and humid where I am right now. And it was not pumping out cool air anymore. That was the complaint. So when I came over early this morning to take a look, the air conditioning lines, the refrigerant lines, were icing over. And that's not a good sign. So literally on the outside here, these were cold enough where there was, you know, ice showing on the outside. And that includes not only indoors here where I am, but also outdoors. Now remember, there's two parts of this system that we want to think about. One is the evaporator indoors here, and the other part is the condenser outdoors here. Now the two are connected with these refrigerant lines, and boy, I'm going to try to get in here. I apologize. I think the camera's fogging up. It's so humid out. But these refrigerant lines, when I checked this morning, had ice on them, and that's a bad sign. You never want to see that outdoors here, because if that refrigerant freezes up, it could eventually damage the pump, which is inside the condenser. So when I see that, I immediately shut the system down, and this system has been off for about 6 hours. The ice outdoors disappeared pretty quickly, but let's go take a look indoors. So back inside here, we can see those same refrigerant lines come through the wall, the block wall, this is the foundation, and come out here and end up back here to the evaporator. And what I strongly suspect has happened is that that evaporator froze up with ice and could no longer do its job. So we need to take a look at that. But the important thing I want to, you know, make sure I make clear here is that if this goes on too long, this went on overnight. So as these refrigerant lines freeze, if that gets its way back all the way to the pump on the outside, you could damage the pump and then you're going to replace the pump. So hopefully we've avoided that, but I don't really know yet. In any case, what I want to do now here is open up this box and see what the condition of that evaporator is. Even though it's 6 hours later, if I put my hand down here, it still feels cold to the touch. So I suspect there's still some ice in there, even though the system has been off for 6 hours. So let's open this up. We'll take these screws out here and just see what we can find. It's tight quarters in here, but I just want to show you, to get this panel off, there's just a series of screws that I've taken out. All right, I've taken this panel off to expose the evaporator coils here. Now, I have really tight space in here, so you got to forgive me. I'm hitting my head every time I move. But I just want to show you what it looks like in here. Now, there's a set of coils here, and I don't know if you can see that, but back there is another set of coils, so it's kind of like a triangle. And I'll pull back as much as I can here. It's very much like a automotive radiator, same idea. You know, it's got the coils here, and the airflow goes over these coils. And if you want to think about it this way, the coils, the way the refrigeration works is it basically absorb the heat and release that heat back outside. It's more complicated than that, but for the point of this video, that's enough. So airflow is going over these coils, and if these coils freeze up, well, then we got a problem. The air can no longer go over those coils, and you're not going to get cooling out of your air conditioning system. So what I see here is not particularly encouraging. I mean, this is an older system. If I look down here, there is quite a bit of rust. You know, it's not great. I see some water leaking there. I'm somewhat concerned about. There's a pan here, which is plastic. This water right here may be this particular line right here, which should actually be inside. It was not done right originally. That may be all that is. But this plastic pan hopefully contains the water that normally drips off. In other words, condensation is normally part of this process. And it collects in that pan. And by moving out here, it comes out here into this pipe and into the condensate pump. So hopefully that's not leaking. But what we're worried about is this freezing area here. Now, like I said, it's been 6 hours. I don't see any visible ice right now, but it is still very cold here. So I suspect, you know, inside here where I can't see very well, there may still be some ice. And we want to make sure we give that a chance to, you know, melt. We don't want that. But the question arises, why is this happening? So there are a number of reasons why this could be happening. One of which is if you don't have adequate airflow over these coils, then you know the slower air doesn't remove the water fast enough, and you can start to get freezing in those coils. I guess is the simplest way I can try to put it. Is that the case here? Well, probably not. Now, the way that would happen would be maybe there were some vents, return vents or something got closed in the house, so the airflow is not what it should be. Maybe there's a problem with the fan. Maybe the furnace filter is clogged up. And maybe the coils themselves are just really dirty. So there are all those sorts of reasons that would reduce airflow, and that could potentially cause freezing. But in this case, I don't think that's it, because nothing has changed. The furnace filter is fairly clean, and the fan seems to be working as it should be. So I don't really think that's the issue here. But as far as the evaporator, what a homeowner could do is pull this panel off, make sure there isn't a whole bunch of dirt or dust caught in here. If there is a whole bunch of ice, by removing the panel, you may, you know, allow the ice to melt a little faster. You could even take a hairdryer to it to help it melt a little faster. It will melt, collect in this pan here, condensate pan, and it should come out this pipe here. So that's another thing you can check, is to make sure this pan is, you know, secure, it's collecting water, the water's going out, and it's not filled with a whole bunch of dirt or anything like that. All right, now I've pulled the covers. I'll try to get back here as much as I can. I pulled the covers off, so this one just yanks upward, and this one comes out as well. And that right here is the control board. We're going to look at that more closely in a second. But I just want to point something else out, which is, if I get close down here, you can see there's dampness on this floor. So water has gotten down there, and that's not good. We do not want to see water in this area at all. So it has leaked. If I bring the camera back up and look for areas where it might have come down, I don't really see anything else that's wet. One possible thing could be just that this pipe, as it had ice, this is the condensate pipe, as ice was going through it, or very cold water, it was getting condensation. In fact, you can see a drip right there. And possibly that's all I'm looking at, is this pipe dripping. In fact, as I look here, I can see some water dripping off here too. So that's probably all it is. The water dripped down and ended up down here. But we want to pay attention here, because if this water is coming from the condensate pan underneath the evaporator, then that's a problem. That means the pan is leaking. All right, if I get up close and personal with the control board here, I don't see any obvious damage. I did do another video about this control board, so that might be something you want to reference. But what I would be looking for are burn or scorch marks where a capacitor is popped, or any other kind of, you know, a wire disconnected, anything loose. I don't see anything that concerns me here. It all looks pretty good. Part of it is covered by a plastic cover here. So I could take the control board off. I could take these screws out. And I could take this off and look on the back side. But I really don't see anything obvious. You see some scorch marks here. That's actually from the previous control board. And check out that video if you want to see that. But this is a newer one. I don't see any issues, so I don't think this was the problem. All right, so where does that leave us now? The control board in this case is not the problem, we don't think. There's no reduced airflow that I can see. You know, the furnace filter is fine. The fan was working fine. That all looks okay. So really back to this area here. So what I'd like to do is, I'm not going to get all this on camera, but I'm going to try to clean this up as best I can. So I'm going to get a wet vac, kind of suck out all that water down there. I may get a hair dryer and just blow across this just to try to reduce some of the remaining ice that's in there. So we'll get that taken care of. And then I want to look over here where this condensate pipe is attached to the tray. And I want to see if there's anything in there clogging that. Is excess water building up in this tray? That's something we can look at. If there's excess moisture in here, you know, potentially that's an issue. I don't know. But there's not much more a homeowner is going to be able to do. All right, I've sprayed down the condenser coils with some degreasing spray, not a whole lot. I don't want to go crazy with that soap. But I'm going to use a deck sprayer. Basically, this is just water in here. And you pump this up if you haven't used one of these, so you get some pressure, and it has a wand, which is great for getting into tight areas that I can't otherwise reach. So this will allow me to spray down the evaporator coils and just get any excess dirt, and also help melt a little bit of the ice if there's any left as well. But I don't want to go nuts with this, and what I want to see is, as I pump water over those, I want it to get into the condensate pan, and I want to see that pan drain into this pipe and into the condensate pump. So as I'm spraying down there, I'm going to be watching that water's not going anywhere else and that I hear this pump come on from time to time. Now, having said that, this pump needs to be powered, but the control board and all the other electronics in here, I got water, so I don't want to spray those with water accidentally. So I have this shut off, but you may need to power the pump from a different source temporarily, just so this continues to pump out any water that we're washing over the evaporator coils. Now the coils on the opposite side are more difficult to get to. There is a panel here, but you have the refrigerant lines going in. So I could take the panel off and kind of back it off far enough where I can get that wand in there and do some cleaning. And if I can get a look in there, I'll probably need a flashlight. I can just double check there isn't dirt or anything blocking the condensate pan pipe that leads out. All right, I've cleaned out as much as I can get. There's still rust and dirt in there, but you're never going to get all of that. But at least I know the coils are somewhat clean. I used that degreaser, and then I sprayed them down with water, and I tried to do both sides as best I can with that pressure washer. Now, I don't want to turn the air conditioning back on yet, that's for sure, because there's too much water and stuff in here, and I could just get a freeze-up again. What I want to do is get a hair dryer and dry this out as best I can, make sure all the ice is gone, make sure it's room temperature before I go turning this thing back on. Or you could also close this back up and use the blower itself, not on air conditioning, but just on the fan setting, and that would help clear out the moisture as well. But since everything's open right here, I'm just gonna grab a hair dryer and see what I can do. Okay, the system is switched back on. Right now, I just have it running on fan. I'll give that a second just to clear out anything else I've left behind in there. Now, I'm gonna turn it on in the air conditioning setting. What am I gonna do? I'm gonna look first outdoors. I wanna check that condenser. I don't wanna hear any funny noises coming from the pump or anything unusual out there. If I hear anything weird, I'm gonna shut the system down and call a pro. And of course, the second thing I'm gonna look for is the temperature coming out of the vents. When I turn this on the air conditioning setting, within, you know, I don't know, 4 or 5 minutes, I want to start feeling cool air coming through those vents. If I don't, if it doesn't feel, you know, cool, then there may not be enough refrigerant in the system and I need to call a pro. Okay, back outside here, condenser is running. The air does feel warmer than the ambient air, although not by a lot. I'll have to give that a little bit of time. And I'll just keep checking back here to make sure I don't have any ice forming. Now here at a vent, you know, it is cool air coming out. I would say it's super cool, but it's cooler. So we're going to watch that too. I think probably this system is a little bit low on refrigerant. And if it is low, then it's got a leak somewhere. It might be a slow leak, might not be anything major, but it might have just leaked out enough. So we'll keep watching this, but there's really nothing more I could do at this point but to call a pro, have them check the refrigerant level and the pressures.